The megastars, the millionaires, the masterminds. Seriously wealthy, glamorous, and influential. They are the rich and famous. They make millions of dollars a year and they know how to spend it. These big spenders of the movie and music industry have money burning a hole in their pocket. Britney Spears. She began her career as a pretty pop princess whose innocence was idolised. But now, this pop diva has created more headlines worldwide and caused more controversy than most stars of our generation. We have grown with her and watched her transformation from innocent young teen to rebellious wild beauty, which has made her the $150 million girl she is today. Britney Spears had achieved it all by her mid-20s. This starlet began her career at an early age, appearing on Disney Channel's The Mickey Mouse Club alongside former Flame Justin Timberlake. She has had a string of number one hits and chart-topping albums and is worshipped by fans worldwide. Thanks to her chart-topping hits Baby One More Time and Oops I Did It Again, Britney was well on her way to being one of the best-selling female artists in American music history. Britney has now sold over 83 million records worldwide, 31 million of them being in the US alone. She has grossed over $150 million from concert ticket sales and $45 million in merchandise from her tours. Her successful music career has led her to a number of guest appearances in film and television and gained her multi-million dollar high-profile advertising deals and endorsements. Britney now has her own perfume line, which made her a tidy profit of approximately $12 million. Her fragrances all seem to tell a story and have some kind of relevance in her life. Her first fragrance was named Curious, which, at the beginning of her career, she was. Her second, Fantasy, because she definitely lives in a fantasy world. And three, In Control. Yeah, okay. Britney, like most young millionaire beauties, has been known to spend a ridiculous amount of money. Roughly $16,000 a month on clothing, around $4,000 plus on eating out, and approximately $17,000 on utility bills, automotive, and other transportation costs. And let's not forget the other $100,000 a month that's used for entertainment, gifts, and vacations. She is known to accept $350,000 to appear at special events. As Britney became more successful, her antics were becoming more outrageous. Marrying good friend Jason Alexander in Vegas after a drunken night, only to have it annulled 55 hours later. Announcing her engagement to second hubby Kevin Federline only a few months later, and locking lips with Madonna at the 2003 MTV Music Awards. The divorce of her much-publicised second marriage and fight for custody of their two children has appeared to be too much for Britney. Always being in the limelight has its pros and cons, as Britney found out. Being snapped nightclubbing and forgetting to wear underwear, and shaving off her long locks after what appeared to be the beginnings of a breakdown. But with all her ups and downs, this young star has achieved more than most people will in their lifetime. And she's still asking, "Gimme more." Michael Jackson. If you take away the fact that he is the face of many changes and has had to fight many controversial court battles, he is still classed the king of pop. Jackson, who has been in the music industry since the age of five and contributed to pop culture for four decades, has been credited as the most successful entertainer of all time. Beginning his career with his brothers in the Jackson 5, he made a name for himself with his R&B gospel sound. Eventually going his own way and concentrating on his solo career, Jackson released a number of albums, receiving massive praise and a huge fan base.
There was something different about this girl. As she stalked the room, I could feel the aura.
His second album, Thriller, became one of the biggest selling albums of all time, with sales skyrocketing. Over 104 million copies of the album were sold.
Dangerous.
Thriller spent 37 weeks in the number one spot and remained in the charts for 122 weeks, eventually to be certified 27 times platinum. This was also around the time of his renowned moonwalk. Ever since then, people in nightclubs around the world have been shuffling their feet along dance floors, trying to perfect the move. When Jackson embarked on his first solo world tour, fans came in droves. The tour lasted over a year, with Jackson performing 123 concerts to over 4.4 million fans. With the dollars flowing in, Jackson purchased the famed Neverland Ranch in Santa Barbara County, California. Named after the island in the story of Peter Pan, Neverland was set on a property of over 2,800 acres and featured a theme park with a number of rides and a zoo. There has been a lot of speculation as to how much Neverland is worth, some saying $6 million, others saying approximately $12 million. Not that it really matters now anyway, the ranch is no longer operating. The 13-time Grammy Award-winning musician, who is known for spending excessive amounts of money, once had the set of a music video flown across an ocean to him so he could finish off the project. Also, when on his way to visit good friend Elizabeth Taylor at the Bellagio in Las Vegas, Jackson had to make a quick stop to purchase a gift for her, a $10,000 bottle of perfume. For $10,000, that would want to be one sweet-smelling perfume. For many years, Jackson has been involved in many charities, helping to raise funds for underprivileged children and beginning and donating $1.5 million to his own Michael Jackson Burn Center, set up in his honour after an incident involving his hair and fire. It has been said that Jackson has given out $300 million all up to charities. At least his spending habits have done some good, which in turn helped him gain a nomination for the Nobel Peace Prize. Even with Jackson's spending ways, he still has a 50% share in Sony ATV, which is worth around $500 million, and has ownership to the publishing rights of most of the Beatles songs. At least with this kind of investment, Wacko Jacko still appears to have his head screwed on. Carrey has been one of the most sought-after comedic actors of our generation. It's hard to imagine that this actor was once poor, being able to demand $20 million for his films. And why can he demand so much per film? They have grossed over $3.5 billion worldwide. In 1994 alone, his films generated a massive $550 million. Jim was one of the first comedic actors to receive a $20 million paycheck and has had 10 films surpass the $100 million mark at the box office. With the success of his films The Mask, Dumb and Dumber, Liar Liar and The Truman Show, Jim is now one of Hollywood's A-list actors. Not wanting to be known just as a funny man, Jim has also received critical success in more dramatic roles. His roles in Man on the Moon and Eternal Sunshine of the Spotless Mind left an impression that he is a dramatic and talented actor. He has taken home a number of awards, including 2 Golden Globes, 4 Blockbuster Entertainment Awards, and a mammoth 10 MTV Movie Awards. And will we see him one day take home that prestigious Oscar? Who knows? As unpredictable as Jim is, it could be just around the corner. If I don't do exactly what they know, whether it's just his wacky ways or not, Jim manages to find coincidences in some of the roles he plays. For example, he shares the same birthday with his real-life character Andy Kaufman in the movie Man on the Moon. I think you're a bunch of dirty scoundrels. And he landed his dream role in The Number 23, a thriller about a man who becomes obsessed with that number. In real life, Jim is also obsessed with this number after being introduced to the idea of it years ago by a friend. It keeps popping up in his life, and he can't decide whether it's a good or bad omen. He has even come to change the name of his company to JC23. With his recent experimentation into dramatic films, Jim happily took a small pay cut. But not before buying his very own personal aircraft. He has now joined the elite club of other A-list celebrities to own their very own aircraft. He purchased a Gulfstream V business jet, which is said to have cost him around $41 million. Joining with John Travolta and Tom Cruise, he can now also be seen jet-setting about. He owns a Celine S7, the same model car he can be seen driving in his film Bruce Almighty. The Celine S7 reportedly costs over $500,000 and can go from 0 to 60 in 3 seconds.
Really, really cool girl.
A fast-paced life seems like a good excuse to get a fast car. To add to this, what seems like a midlife crisis purchase, Jim spent $9.5 million on a home in Malibu. The home is said to be a glass happy beach house that has been refurbished and expanded, including a master suite on the water. Even with a small pay cut and experimenting with different movie roles, life for Jim Carrey is still smoking. She has the voice of an angel and the body of a goddess. With a string of number one hits, it's safe to say that Mariah Carey is one of the most successful female artists of our time, with an estimated worth in the hundreds of millions of dollars. This American pop and R&B singer made a name for herself in the early 90s with the release of her self-titled album, Mariah Carey. It managed 4 number one hits and has been one of her most successful albums. Mariah is well known for her vocal range, power, and melismatic style, which has helped her to win a number of Grammy Awards and sell millions of albums worldwide. Her five-octave voice has made her one of the world's biggest divas in pop music history. With all this success, she was now one of the biggest celebrities of our time. Mariah eventually married former Sony Music president Thomas Mottola in a lavish $500,000 wedding. She wore an off-the-shoulder Vera Wang pale ivory dress with a 27-foot-long train and a Princess Diana-style tiara, trailed by an English tulle veil sprinkled with rhinestones. She apparently also needed 50 flower girls. She purchased a penthouse in 1999 for an estimated $9 million. That price included two apartments, a bargain buy. The penthouse duplex and a single floor apartment below the penthouse were renovated into one large apartment. With the pressure of showbiz life, Mariah suffered from what her publicist refers to as a physical and emotional breakdown. Although it didn't take her long to get back into the swing of things. She released more albums which conveyed a new sound and image for Mariah. She was back with more sex appeal and seemed to have left behind the innocent girl next door. Maybe the divorce from her husband can be thanked for that. Mariah then signed a contract with the shaving company giant Gillette to head their Legs of a Goddess advertisement campaign. This then led to Mariah insuring her long legs for $1 billion. At least she knows she's covered if she cuts them shaving.
Well, I don't really like to talk about money, but I would definitely say that if your legs were insured for $1 billion, it wouldn't really be the best thing to go around talking about it.
Mariah's 10th studio album, The Emancipation of Mimi, showed she had more to offer, becoming 2005's best-selling album in the US and earning her another Grammy Award. Her Adventures of Mimi tour raked in over $26 million in ticket sales. She has received the Billboard's Artist of the Decade Award and the World Music Award for best-selling female artist of the millennium. Mariah is also involved in a number of charities and has been known to donate a percentage of her sales to a number of organisations. She has participated in a number of benefit concerts to help raise money for the survivors of the September 11 attacks and Hurricane Katrina. Mariah is now participating in a number of endorsement deals, including promoting the Intel-Centrino duo, and has launched a jewellery and accessory line glamorised for teenagers. She signed a licensing deal with cosmetics company Elizabeth Arden and released her first fragrance, M. And life sure smells pretty for this pop diva. Flamboyant, glamorous, rich. Elton John, he is one of the world's best musicians and performers, packing stadiums and selling out concerts worldwide. With his over-the-top fashion designs and sparkling spectacles, he has now made himself one of the richest rock and roll legends around, with a small fortune of $500 million. With a career that spans over four decades, Elton has given us some great hits such as Crocodile Rock, Candle in the Wind, and Rocket Man. He has had more than 50 top 40 hits, 16 top 10 hits, 4 number 2 hits, and 9 number 1s. Luckily for him, he has had such success, needing all that cash to support his spending habit. He has been known to spend over $50 million in just under 2 years. That's almost $3 million a month. Not even a rocket man could earn that kind of money. In just under 2 years, he managed to purchase $18 million worth of property and spend around $500,000 on flowers. When asked why he spent that much on flowers, he replied with, "I like flowers." Just admit it, Elton, it's simply because you can. When a special occasion arises, Elton celebrates in style. For his 50th, he threw a birthday bash and dressed himself up as Louis XIV, with the costume costing more than $80,000. On his 60th, he performed at Madison Square Gardens for the 60th time to mark his birthday. And to celebrate his civil partnership with longtime partner David Furnish, Elton and David partook in a low-key ceremony, followed by a lavish party, said to have cost almost $2 million. Elton, who had acquired a nice little collection of 28 cars, decided that he didn't have time to drive them all, so he sold 20 of them. The sale raised over $3 million. He also owns more than 2,000 paintings, some worth over $1 million. Elton, who announced in the 70s that he was bisexual, later retracting it saying he was gay, has heavily been involved in the fight against AIDS since the late 80s. He established the Elton John AIDS Foundation in 1992 with the intention of having 90% of the funds raised go to direct care and 10% to AIDS prevention education.
We are a very small foundation, and I wanted to keep it like that because you can, you know, get a grip and keep an eye on what's going on. We don't want to become too large. We're very streamlined. But we're now up past the $150 million mark, and, you know, we're very, very happy with that. And, you know, we still have a lot of work to do because I can't see in my lifetime this ever stopping. So even if they find a cure and they find a vaccine, there are going to be so many people who still are infected with HIV that we have to support throughout the world.
This being one of his passions, Elton hosts annually a white tie and tiara ball with many famous celebrities on the guest list. Some years, the ball has raised almost $9 million with the auctioning of some very expensive pieces. Tickets to the ball will cost anyone almost $2,000. One of Elton's most successful songs to date was the altered version of Candle in the Wind. He performed this version at the funeral for his friend Diana, Princess of Wales. With the highs and lows of his career, suffering personal battles against drugs, depression, and bulimia, Elton has one thing he will never have to battle against: bankruptcy.